the regal bastard, who is the last character of these three albums. You had the widow, the bride. The regal bastard is actually the quartermaster. You know, what happened to him? But the regal bastard can be many things. It is the quartermaster in one way. It is also my father. There's another song on the album called Wahoo, where, you know, the bastard, if you like, ended up there. And my dad lived in Oahu for 18 years. And so there's some hidden messages in there that maybe only he can catch. I don't know. And also the regal bastard is actually the guy that my mother always wanted me to be, that I never really, she knew, never really fully accepted me for the person I was. We always had conflicts over certain things, how I wore my hair, how I dressed and stuff like that. We were also very often on a collision course, though we loved each other to bits. But so it's all of that. You know, I have many years of life experience now that I'm summing up in my lyrics. So the whole album, mostly the lyrics on the album are metaphors for what has happened through my life. It's also one song that's one of my favorite songs called Woe, Always Being Without You. It's a song that I feel that many people can relate to because it's about that big break in life. You know, you have your own house, or you're happy, you think you're happy. Well, you might even believe you're happy. But that thing that I'm just waiting for, win the lottery or find the love of your life or something that was like, oh, whoa, where did that come from? That kind of a thing. And also it's a little bit like, for me, I was having a day job for many, many, many years. And I sort of gave up on the idea of being an artist because it wouldn't happen until Steve Hackett called me. And that was my whoa moment, you know. So it reflects a little bit of my own experience, but I can feel that a lot of people out there can really relate to the lyrics. And then, of course, you have the Regal Bastard, the title track, which is 12 and a half minutes long. And it is a beautiful journey through progressive rock, I feel. Very classical, more classical so than anything else I've done. It's a standout piece on its own right, but my personal real favorite is Leave Me on This Waters, being linked to Honey, I'm Home. Honey, I'm Home is where I revisit Carry Me Home and bits from Long Slow Crash Landing and from my previous albums. And also actually it's a little reference to Whoa as well, musically, that theme coming back again. But Leave Me on This Waters was a song that an idea I had in my head for years. It just grew and grew and grew. Just came back to that idea. I heard it, I had the chorus, I had everything in the head, you know. So I just said to myself, I've got to write this down, I've got to record it. And so I did, and to me that became my favorite song. And also Guthrie Govan plays a tremendous solo on that one, very bluesy, very, very melodic. So I'm extremely happy with this album, and I hope you will be too. So deep in the heart of the moment.